This video is on the French EBR in War Thunder at 4.3 BR. Hope you guys enjoy this intro. SU boy. Is this guy getting shot here? God, the fuel tank fire. When you hit something in the fuel tank now, it's really impressive. Oh, I hit low. Where is this Yagi boy? Oh, he just moved. Yeah, he crashed into a tree. Okay, this guy's now pushed me. I'm fully. Time to reverse. That tiger's still waiting on me as well. Oh, gone. Yeah, he's gone. Good. This, oh my god, I was going to say, is he dead? yeah, he's dead. You know something that's funny? If you're holding down your C key, sometimes it's difficult to know which side of your tank is facing where. A NATO! Okay, he's dead and the guy behind me is dead too. Smoking out. Oh my god, those smokes got launched pretty far. Damn it, dude. Holy crap. Salut and welcome back to the channel. This video is on the most under-tiered vehicle Gaijin has probably ever added. This is the French EBR. And at this point, it's like Gaijin doing this blatant marketing just to make sure that people really want to grind out the event to get this thing. Now, if this guy, the M41 FL10, wasn't under-tiered, this thing has the exact same turret, but at 4.3 and on a pretty quick chassis. For anyone who does not know, this thing has a 5-second reload, and it fires an armor-piercing capped shell with 182mm of pen. Now, sure, in a full Uptier, this thing will face 5.3 vehicles, which includes the Panther D and the Mighty Tiger. Its armor is fairly pathetic as well, but it is a light tank and it gets the scout too. But by far my favorite feature about this vehicle is that it's completely symmetrical. And the hull effectively has the exact same layout as your mother's double-sided dill. The engine as well and the transmission are completely flat-packed IKEA'd right down at the bottom of the hull too, and that makes it unlikely for things that are shooting through your side with AP shells to actually do any damage to any components. Now, for the sake of this video, I'm actually going to be bringing it out with 4.7 lineup just to see how it'll do in a full up tier at 5.7, because I know in full reality at 4.3 this thing is going to be doing very well. Oh, and here's the stat card if anyone wants to see it. Alright, let's hop into battle. Right, not the best map. I just played a game on Frozen Pass. And I crashed 3 times. Ghost shells and stuff. I don't know what is going on. This is EU only. So, it's not my internet. Did an old testaroo and my, okay. Well, my usual testing subject is CSGO. So it's definitely Gaijigal servers. Tank seems to phase out of existence when you're going near objects. It's definitely a weird bug. I'm pretty convinced that Gaijin's testers like, oh, okay. Is this where we live now? Yeah, I'm sure they just test the tanks in test drive and don't actually take them out into games. What on earth is going on here? I've managed to wriggle my way out of that. It's like the armor doesn't clip on the terrain, but the engine does. And the transmission, running gear, etc. Those still clip. I'm hearing lots of noise down here. A hootsa. Was driving it. Oh. And a Panzer IV. And a Puma. The whole solid shot is an issue. What is that? The hits are there. Yeah, he's here. I need to be careful people don't come out in front of me. Good thing we're having an auto though that is engaging multiple targets on a flank is very nice. Is there a gap here? Yeah, kinda. Not big enough to drive through, big enough to shoot through though. Let's be very wary as we peek this. Someone is... Oh, it was too high. Someone's really close here as well. Oh god. We're in a really nice spot, but... we're also in a very dangerous spot. I'm just gonna hang out here for a little while, probably. Enemy aircraft coming in. Hopefully not after me. This is a very advantageous place to be. With an autoloader especially. I'm worried in case I murder an Italian man and he comes hunting after me with an R3. Yeah, they're still on the aircap. Nothing can really push the street right now with me here. I could try the next street down. Oh. Someone's right on that corner. Wait, SU-85's got that covered now. That is a big hit on him. Let's get him finished off. This is pretty... Oh, look what it is. Look what it is. Get out of here, dude. And now, we just sit in this crossfire, I suppose. We're going to be a real nuisance over here. One, difficult to spot. Two, autoloader. Three, high pen. Four, scouting. Oh, an A21. That SU-85's got a lot of pressure on the enemy team as well. Nobody's pushing out. They're all stuck. I want to see that A21 gone. Being hunted. Panzer 4H coming this way. And something closer. I like when they turn at an angle like that. Means I can get at least 4 crew members. Just sitting here. Low effort. High reward gameplay. To be honest, I could be doing this in any tank. It's just that if a Tiger pops out, it's gonna be easy meat. Oh. Not for me yet. I'm sure my time will come though. Another one. The Stuka. Sacrificed his life. For an M10. Look at our team dying to all the aircraft. Doesn't seem to matter though. Do you know what would be my worst nightmare? A whirlwind. I think we go to the next street over again. But I have no cover this way though. That thing also. Terrifying nightmare. This is the most overpowered tank for 4.3 I've played in a long time. Is that a whirlwind? Is that what I think it is? Yes, sir. Oh, no ammo rack, by the way. God, it's crew though. An ace. Double ace, sorry. Need to get his driver from here, which I don't think I can. He blew up. Double ace plus one. And that's going to be game. Yeah. Oh, load up 4.3. Well, we are at 4.7, technically. But having the extra bit of speed is definitely beneficial. Oh, GG. Good lord. What better way... Oh. What better way to test out Wheelie Boy on a full up tier to 5.7 on Fulda. See you guys over there. So, quick intermission. This thing does not like to traverse any sort of hill whatsoever. We can just invisibly go through fences though, which is kind of nice. This ARL is outspeeding us on flat ground. This ARL shot me. How rude. Now I got a gigantic hole in my tank. Wait, what's my gun depression on this? It's not a lot, right? Negative 6 elevation, which is not ideal. It's really strange looking at a vehicle that is literally... How do you explain this? The first thing that came to my head was human centipede, but that's definitely not right. The other thing I was thinking of is like a doppelganger, which I don't think is right either. There's things coming this way. I really wanted to be with an eye shot of people coming over this hill. I thought we'd be fast enough to do that. Here we go though. Oh. Angry Tigor. Oh, that is definitely not what we want to see. T-34's noticed me now, I think. Oh, it's gonna scout him. Hopefully a teammate will pick him up. I'll shoot him again when he starts moving, but while he's got his gun trained in my direction, I'm not re-peeking that. I'm glad I killed that R3 though. There he goes. Tiger waiting on me too? Kinda. There's one other chap here, IS2. I'd like to get a shot on him, to be honest. Here he comes. I tried to bounce my gun down, but it deflected straight back up immediately. He's fired though. Tiger's kinda paying attention as well. That didn't pen him, although it was a fairly decent hit though. Scout him and the tiger again whenever he resurfaces. Okay, good. Destroyed by intelligence gives us more plane spawn points. Another not very successful shot. Sadly, we don't have the ballistic capped ballistic cap round, so going through funny angles like that is next to impossible. Oh, is this guy getting a bomb? No, I thought that may have been another successful kill assist. Oh, he's moving fast too. Oh, there's two of them here. Another bad shot. This is a very high velocity gun, actually. It's honestly thrown me off. still just chilling in the bushes. Oh yeah, both of them are. There's one. We're reloading very quickly. Another side shot. Commander gunner and loader out on him. I've got a little bit of concealment from these bushes. Let's scout that mad lad. And just back off a little bit again. We're a light tank after all. Hey, what up F6F? Looking good, buddy. Right, T-Gor. He actually driven off through the smoke. Oh, he's moving this way. Yeah, too much of an angle. That was to be expected. Oh, we got a guy up here. Where's all the Panthers at? That's what I want to know. Take her. I only killed his commander, sadly. That was a much more successful hit. I'm trying to get through to his engine so I can stop him from moving. Well, his breech is out. And he's been murdered by our fellow in a B-47. Oh yeah, that's the premium French boy. Right, how are we looking on ammo? We got two rounds left before we need to replenish the entire thing. I'm just gonna keep pushing up here. Our mortal enemy, the R3. There could be more of them. I haven't seen very many Italians though on the scoreboard. It's good to have air support though, especially if they start machine gunning things for us.
We've captured most of the strategic zone.
Try and check the usual spots. Someone is down towards C. Now, the best thing for me to do is push the spawn, but I really don't want to do that right now. Enemy plane up is not a good sign for me. The scent is pushing the bridge. Right, we are going to go this way. Our teammates have everything else covered. And we're losing a hell of a lot of people over near the A-cab too. Let's try and avoid the steep hills when we possibly can for a couple of reasons. One. No gun depression. Two, slows us right down. Oh god, yeah, he got clipped. We got quite a few guys out here. Now we should be able to use our pretty quick reverse speed. We get a few shots on these guys. Oh, that's a T-34-85. That is a very big hit. I don't know if the Tiger spotted me. Too high. Might die here. Oh, we're good. A KV-1, that can kill me no problem. Not anymore though. Oh my god, dude. Right, we'll get one more shot on this KV-1 and we'll need to back off. A ricochet. Okay, maybe one more. let's actually scout for this M6 in case I don't get the kill and blow on him. Yeah, still again. You want to hit this dude, M6? I think he bounced him too. Oh, he's returning fire now. Let's go for the... another shot. Right, I think we've got one left. Yeah, just a single one. Is that an enemy there? Is he just shooting at dead tanks? Oh, a Hetzer. I'm really sorry, buddy. Right, there goes my ammo storage completely gone. Right, B has been capped by the enemy. I'm not doing that. Oh, I've completely run out of ammo. Right, so not ideal. We did end up with 6 kills and 7 assists though, which is extreme light tank behavior. Oh, little chap. M6, I really need your help here, dude. Wonder how long I can survive just evading this guy until this M4 comes along to take him out. I think it's a Delatom. It might actually be something much earlier than that, though. Yeah, it was a Delatom. Thank you, dude. And off we go to the B-cap. Is this guy still alive? No. This. Did we got the assist on? Dicker. That's someone we killed earlier too. Right, we're on level caps. Oh, someone's on B. Churchill. Now, this thing's a bit buggy right now. Obviously, we're testing it. So we can sometimes phase through walls and stuff, which is very unusual. So I'm going to try and avoid doing that. It's a little bit cheaty. There's lots of enemies left. The good news is when we start replenishing our ammo here, it goes straight into the autoloader. So we can just chill for a minute or two. Oh my god. I can definitely see that Key61 coming back to murder me. Most, if I'm in a plane and I see a wheeled vehicle, it definitely gets shot at. M18's coming. I might actually distract this. I can't avoid this guy's approach. Next to impossible. I'm just going to have to sit here and take it. I would like to get another 4 kills. That'd be nice. But we are going to need more ammo for that job. Right, 10 rounds should do it. Let's see if we are at least decently fast on our road. Watch me run out of ammo again. So we got one light tank watching their spawn where we were originally. And really the only reason I drove there is because there was nothing else to do. There's quite a few enemies. Enough to get a double ace in my first game for sure. This man looks very angry. There's an SPAA shooting as well from over here. That looks like a Zis. Oh, that came from out of the map, I think. I got shot from really close. And I've... Oh god, he was up to my left. Where is this guy? He drift right... the Churchill driven right past him too. Oh well, no double ace for me. There he is. God, he was right there too. Someone asked me what the BR was of this thing. The EBR, I mean. Right, they're back on C. I think I can see him. Yeah, he's on the road. I don't know whether to bomb him. I'm actually not sure what it is. Oh, here we go. This probably is a much more suitable target for some big bombs. He's very dead. This guy I think is a KV. I'm gonna let him run away because I don't have the armament to kill him. One dude driving clear through. There's one here as well. Another Dilatom or something? Pivkiv. And an IS or a T-34 there. Oh god, that KV-1 actually beat that M4 A1 down there. Ah, I just missed him with a rocket. Oh, plane coming in. God, my aim. Oh god, that is, I lost my elevator there. He'd probably get the kill for me too. Now, I don't know if he was like lagging towards me. I knew he was coming in for a head on though. And there was nothing I could do about it. Yeah, he got the kill for me, but I didn't get the kill for him. I got 6 more assists in this. My god. Another enemy plane up. A yak for sure. This is gonna be game though. Yeah. Oh, I got him too. GG. So I expect a lot of people are going to ask me, is this vehicle worth it? And I'm going to give you a big resounding yes. Even if this thing gets shoveled up to 4.7 or even 5.0 or 5.3, it's still going to be very good. And as it sits at 4.3, it's definitely one of the better vehicles around this battle rating. Now, sure, it can't really take a hit, but when you compare it to other things, like this guy is 6.3, yeah, that is the exact same turret, and this guy doesn't have very good armor either. So if you're a tanker and you're looking at picking up a light tank for your French lineup, especially for 4.7, I would definitely go out of my way to bag this thing before it ends up in the marketplace at a very inflated price. Oh, and by the way, we hit 60,000 subscribers on the channel after that last video, so thank you guys very much for being subscribed. And to all my patrons over on Patreon, thank you for all of your help through this difficult year for me. And a huge shout out to the tier 3 folks over there. That's Matthew S, Jesse Mills, Thumpin' Bunny, Houndy, Gateway, Bilal, Trash Panda, Rige, Sailcat, Zema, Kane the Salt Lord, Viking Gods, Warpig, The Firepiper, Sexy, Varian, Yuckbo, Justin Darlin, Jay Thormy, and Fearsome Scotsman. You guys are all awesome. And to everyone who's watching the video, thank you very much for watching. Much love, and bye-bye.